Welcome to an example on how to add two fractions with unlike denominators. The most important thing to remember when adding or subtracting fractions is that we must have a common denominator. The reason we need a common denominator is so that we're adding or subtracting pieces or parts of the same size. Once we have a common denominator to add two fractions, the denominator stays the same and we add the numerators. So looking at our example, we have 1/4 plus 1/2. Notice how we do not have a common denominator, and therefore we cannot add the fractions in this form. If we find the smallest possible common denominator, it's called the least common denominator, which would be the least common multiple of 4 and 2, which would be the smallest number that's divisible by 4 and 2. So if we recognize that 4 is the least common multiple of 4 and 2, then we need to write both fractions with the denominator of 4. So looking at the fraction of 1/2, we want an equivalent fraction with the denominator of 4, and therefore we multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. This will give us an equivalent fraction with the denominator of 4. So we'd have 1/4 plus 2/4, and now we have a common denominator. We can add the two fractions, the denominator stays the same, and we add the numerators. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. The sum is 3/4. Let's look at a model of this sum. So if we define the rectangle as one whole, here we have a model for 1/4, here we have a model for 1/2. To combine these two amounts, we want the parts or pieces to be the same size. So looking at the model of 1/2, if we cut or partition the rectangle into 4 equal parts or pieces, it would look like this. Notice by doing this, all the pieces are the same size, which also shows that 1/2 is equivalent to 2/4, which is what we have here. So we can write the sum as 1/4 plus 2/4. We already know the sum is 3/4 from above, but using our model, notice how if we combine these pieces, we have a total of 1, 2, 3 pieces, where each piece has a size of 1/4, giving us a sum of 3/4. So this is how we find the sum using the least common denominator, but I do want to show this again using a common denominator that is not the least common denominator. So going back to the original sum of 1/4 plus 1/2, if we're ever not able to determine the least common denominator, any common denominator will work. To find a common denominator, we can always just multiply the denominators together. 4 times 2 is equal to 8, so we could use 8 as a common denominator. If we did want to use 8 as a common denominator for 1/4, we'd have to multiply the numerator and denominator by 2 to create an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 8, and for 1/2, we have to multiply by 4. Notice here we have 2/8 plus 4/8. We have a common denominator, so to find the sum, the denominator remains 8, and the numerator is 2 plus 4, which equals 6. So 6/8 is equivalent to 3/4, but it does simplify because 6 and 8 share a common factor of 2. To show the factor of 2, we could write 6 as 2 times 3 and 8 as 2 times 4, where 2 divided by 2 simplifies to 1, giving us the same sum of 3/4. Of course, we can also show the simplifying of 6/8 by dividing the numerator and denominator by 2, which gives us the same result of 3/4. I hope you found this helpful.